I am a psychiatrist at Massachusetts General Hospital, and I am an entrepreneur and a Blavatnik Fellow.
I'm a mother of two, a practicing physician, and a Blavatnik Fellow.
I am in the MBA class of 2018 at Harvard Business School. I was an engineer, and now as an entrepreneur, I'll be joining the Blavatnik Fellowship.
I am a PhD trained scientist, an entrepreneur, and a Blavatnik Fellow.
I'm a MBA 2018, an entrepreneur in the biotechnology space, and a Blavatnik Fellow.
Business people look at doctors and say they don't understand the numbers. Doctors look at business people and say all they care about are the numbers. When in reality, we really need a collaboration between the two fields. I am the co-founder and medical director for Valera Health, and what we do is we enable healthcare organizations to provide the most effective and efficient behavioral healthcare. The way we started was really a few of us getting in a room and saying, why isn't anyone using technology to change how mental health is delivered? I feel as physicians, the most important thing is to meet your patients where your patients are. And frankly, today, most people use digital devices. We provide a way to improve communications between the patient and their healthcare team. I believe the Blavatnik Fellowship will allow me to interact with some of the top professors, venture capitalists, insurance companies, and thought leaders in the industry. And this will definitely accelerate the development of my startup.
We are the country with the greatest spend and not the greatest outcomes. Neurological diseases such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's are a huge unmet need. This is really where I want to focus my efforts. I really love science, but my PhD experience made me realize that I didn't want to be on the bench doing the actual science. But I really was interested in the commercialization and the development of drugs to really have an impact on human health. I've had the Blavatnik flyer on my corkboard since I think they had club day here first year. When I was deciding not to go back to the company where I did my internship, I decided to apply for the Blavatnik Fellowship and give it a go at trying to create a new venture. What I hope to accomplish during the Blavatnik Fellowship is to identify the technology, license it, and in that time, you know, raise some money.
There's no shortage of problems to solve, I think, in the world today. And our goal and maybe responsibility as engineers and then also as business people is to try and maximize the amount of good that we can do. X-COR Therapeutics is about creating a respiratory dialysis system so that patients with failing lungs do not have to be intubated or mechanically ventilated, but rather can have small, low-flow amounts of blood drawn and then have their buildup of CO2 due to the respiratory disease vented out of their body.
How hard would it be?
Right before the fellowship starts in May, we'll be traveling to Shanghai to do our next set of preclinical studies. We can then kind of springboard into the fellowship year. We absolutely realize that fundraising in itself is not success. We need to be able to prove the underlying science, create the products themselves, and then be able to show that they're safe and useful.
Mouth and say, ah.
As a physician, you know, I always thought I could be able to help the world and do so many things with my medical skills, but when I became a patient myself, it sort of changed my life.
Like
I feel so thankful for the specialist that I saw, and now I have two children because of it. InfiniteMD helps international patients, but mostly Chinese patients, that's our main business right now, get second opinions about cancer, neurology, cardiology, and a few other areas, because there's a huge need in China for specialists, but not so much of the specialty that's available. We have a system, a platform that translates everything through providers and interpreters and translators. And then we set up a video consultation with the physician here. Over the next year of the Blavatnik Fellowship, I hope to grow InfiniteMD. We'd like to have several employers and insurance companies on our system. I've always desired to be part of the China story. I'm from China, my parents are from China, and so I just felt a calling to stay connected, to be part of that burgeoning industry of healthcare, but also to sort of give back to those that don't have access to the best care.
My brother inspired the reason to be here. He was born with a genetic disorder called Duchenne muscular dystrophy. The foundation I started is called Terry's Foundation for Muscular Dystrophy, named after my brother. And that's how I met Dr. Lou Kunkel, world-renowned geneticist, who discovered the dystrophin gene back in 1986, the gene that's responsible for the disease. In addition to Terry's Foundation, I've started a company called Myos, who is working with the Kunkel Lab on developing a new approach to cell therapy. Boiling it down, it really comes to the point of how do you get healthy muscle cells when you inject them into the body to go to the muscle sites that you want and then to fuse to the healthy muscle there. And that's what we're working on in the Kunkel Lab and Myos. But what there is a deep need for is there's a deep need for a champion of a project to see it through from the beginning and as far into clinical trial and commercialization as you can get. The Blavatnik Fellowship is key because it's really the crucial segue to allow you to work on the project now. What we're seeing is that the research is reaching a point where it's almost to commercialization, almost to that sweet spot of needing to be licensed from the institution into a startup. The difference that we can make now and continuing it to drive it forward while still in academia can shorten the development timeline and bring us to a point where we can get it into the hands of patients much faster. And so now's the time. Not 2 years from now, not 3 years from now, now.